Good morning. Woo! I am Kelly Simone, principal of Upper Darby High School, and it is my honor to welcome you to the High School Performing Arts Center for the first annual Juneteenth celebration. High school students in the audience, please remain for the entire presentation. Once we conclude, we will dismiss you to your flex so you can eat. All right, don't worry. And right now, we are going to begin our celebration with the Kindergarten Center leading us in the Pledge of Allegiance. So I would like you to please stand.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
All right. My name is Mr. Christopher Lashley. I am the Supervisor of Art, Music, and Theater for the Upper Darby School District, and it is my honor to present to you the first Juneteenth celebration in Upper Darby. Give it a round of applause. It is such a pleasure to see your beautiful faces here this morning. So, I love to teach when it comes to music and give very important lessons about the music that you hear. So the song you're getting ready to hear is called Lift Every Voice and Sing. Lift Every Voice and Sing is actually known as the Black National Anthem. Now, throughout all the civil rights movement, throughout different parts of it, this song was giving strength to the African American community to let them know that even in the trials and tribulations, they're gonna lift their voices and sing for jubilation and for freedom one day. So as I walk up to the podium to have the singers sing, enjoy Lift Every Voice and Sing. Thank you so much.
So
At this time, I would like to welcome our Superintendent of Schools, Dr. Daniel McGarry.
That was beautiful. I want to recognize Mr. Lashley and the music department here at the high school. Chris, it's been a whirlwind tour since we brought you here, and you're meeting all of our expectations. So thanks for getting us to this moment and for celebrating our kids and our community. So thanks, Chris. I appreciate it. I also want to recognize our board of school directors that are here with us. Our board president will be speaking very soon. It takes a lot of courage in today's environment to continue to advocate for the rights of others and for all of you, our students in here sitting with us and the students that are watching us virtually. Our board of school directors are in volunteer positions who have dedicated their lives to making sure that there are equitable opportunities for all of the children that we serve here in this community. Juneteenth is recognized in Upper Darby School District, and especially for this moment today, because our school board of directors made it a point to focus on the true history, and this is important, everybody, the true history of the United States of America. Oftentimes, some of our history books have left out some of those important parts that have built the very fabric of this country. And today, while today is not Juneteenth, it's later on in June, we wanted to have this opportunity to have our students present for what we are turning into a very educational opportunity for all of you. It's so important that you understand who you are, that you understand your history, and that we recognize the real history of this country. I want to recognize Miss Melissa Figueroa Douglas, who is our supervisor of equity. I met with Melissa and Chris and wanted to make sure we put together a wonderful event when our students were in session, so that you understand this important day, this important celebration, is an educational moment. And if we don't remember our history and we aren't educated on a history, we will make poor mistakes moving forward. So thank you for paying attention. Please make sure your cell phones do remain off, because today is an assembly, but it's also a very important educational moment for all of you and for all of you who are watching. With that said, I want to turn this over now to our Assistant Superintendent for Human Resources, but also for Equity, another change in title that our school board made it a focus that equity is the work of this school district. So Dr. Council, if you will, please come to the mic.
Thank you so much. Thank you so much, and welcome everyone. I was told that we have a lot of talent here today and not a lot of time, so I'll keep my remarks very brief. In a spirit of gratitude, Dr. McGarry, I would like to say thank you so much to everyone that had a hand in preparing this Juneteenth event. To all of our students, everyone that's here in the auditorium and everyone that's watching online, I would like to remind you that throughout this month, we'll have people throughout the country celebrating Juneteenth through dance, through song, through education. I do not want it to be lost on anyone, that today we are celebrating excellence, we are celebrating achievement, and we are celebrating African-American culture. Today, here in Upper Darby, give yourselves a hand. And with that said, I say to you, continue to be motivated, continue to be encouraged throughout this day, tomorrow and forevermore. It brings me great pleasure to bring to the microphone the president of our Board of School Directors, Mr. Edward Brown.
I'm excited to be here today, to be a part of this event. If you're excited like I am, just give yourselves a round of applause for being here. I'm thrilled because we're here for Juneteenth. A few years ago, I'm sure many of you or some of you didn't even know what Juneteenth was, right? That's something that's new and common in our vocabulary now, but a few years ago that was not the case. So I'm happy that it is now commonplace and that most people know what Juneteenth is. But I'm just going to give you a little bit of background information just for those who don't know. I don't want to take for granted that everybody knows what it is. So I'm just going to give some basic information. Juneteenth, officially Juneteenth National Independence Day, and also known as Jubilee Day, Emancipation Day, Freedom Day, and Black Independence Day, is a federal holiday in the United States commemorating the emancipation of enslaved African Americans. It is also observed for celebrating African American culture, and we're going to see some of that today. Originating in Galveston, Texas, it has been celebrated annually on June 19th in various parts of the United States since 1865, believe it or not. The day was recognized as a federal holiday on June 17, 2021, when President Joe Biden signed the Juneteenth National Independence Day Act into law. Let's give a round of applause for that fact alone. Juneteenth's commemoration is on the anniversary date of June 19, 1865, announcement of General Order No. 3 by Union Army General Gordon Granger, proclaiming freedom for enslaved people in Texas, which was the last state of the Confederacy with institutionalized slavery. Celebratory traditions often include public readings of the Emancipation Proclamation, singing traditional songs such as Swing Low, Sweet Chariot, and Lift Every Voice and Sing, and reading the works of noted African-American writers such as Ralph Ellison and Maya Angelou. Some other Juneteenth celebrations also include rodeos, street fairs, cookouts, family reunions, park parties, historic reenactments, Miss Juneteenth contests. When Juneteenth became a federal holiday on June 17, 2021, it was the first national holiday since Martin Luther King Jr. Day was adopted in 1983. So, one of the things that our board is certainly keen on diversity and anti-racism and things like that. So, before I read a resolution that our board put together, I'd like to have all my board stand up so we can clap for them and recognize my wonderful team and fellow colleagues on the school board. Rachel Mitchell, Dr. Meredith Haig, and Desiree Lamar Murphy are here with us, and we have all of our other school board directors here in spirit. So we have a resolution that I'm going to read that is for anti-racism. It's an anti-racist resolution, but it fits right in with Juneteenth, so I'm going to read that now. Resolution supporting the development of an anti-racist school climate by the Board of School Directors of the Upper Darby School District. Whereas we are deeply saddened and outraged by the recent killings of George Floyd and the violence against black men and women and children, the subsequent protests have shined a spotlight on the harmful effects of racism and inequity. Furthermore, the public response has highlighted the racial trauma that our black students, families, staff, and communities have not only endured for centuries, but continue to face today. Whereas we must recognize that racism and hate have no place in our schools and society. However, we must understand that racism is systemic, and it is unconscionable and consciously rooted in our institutions, policies, and practices. Consequently, we acknowledge that we must look at our own school policies and practices through an anti-racism and equity lens to address any traces of racism and inequity that still exists within our own school community. Whereas we must center the voices of staff, students, families, and communities who have historically endured discrimination and marginalization, their lived experience and stories require attention, require respect, require empathy, and more importantly, require action. Therefore, it is essential that we establish an expectation that a diversity of staff, students, families, and community members, specifically those that have been ignored, discriminated against, and marginalized, are heard and included on substantive school and district issues. Whereas we must better educate ourselves and seek to educate the community on the historic and current impact of racism and discrimination on our students, families, and communities, as well as understand our role in perpetuating such inequity. Through conscious professional development and opportunities for honest dialogue and listening sessions, we hope to build partnerships in the community focused on overcoming systemic racism and the barriers stemming from and perpetuated by systemic racism. By doing so, we can create opportunities to ensure that each child has the tools and supports needed to thrive. As the district continues to reinforce an inclusive learning environment for all, we must review how our current systems and structures prevent equitable opportunities for the students and communities we serve, including the curriculum and resources we provide, as well as the staff we hire. Whereas we must advocate to advance civil rights and cultivate an anti-racist school climate necessary to meet the needs of all students in our care. Our students, no matter their identities, deserve to feel safe, to feel seen, and to feel affirmed, and I'll add, to be heard. Now, therefore, be it resolved
that the Upper Darby School Board unequivocally stand firm in our collective responsibility to foster an equitable and inclusive environment for every student, staff member, parent, and community member. We commit to use our role as school board directors to recognize, respond, and speak out against any injustice and racist and racial inequity in our school community. In support of this goal, the Upper Darby School Board commits to the following action steps. Action one area, constructing and enacting an equitable vision. Action area two, engaging in self-reflection and growth. Action area three, collaborating with families and community. Action area four, hiring and placing personnel. These action areas are described in detail within the district's equity plan, Upper Darby School District Comprehensive Equity Plan Proposal 2018 to 2022, located on our website. This was adopted July 14th, 2020, signed by me as the board president and our board secretary, Craig Rogers. Thank you and enjoy the rest of this ceremony.
Now, it is my pleasure to welcome to the stage the Carmen Butler Dance Experience.
My name is Carmen Butler, and the artists that you are about to see are bringing you a taste of West Africa. Before we start, I'd like to thank Mr. Chris Lashley and Sid Lucas for making an opportunity to bring us to you. The dance that you are about to see is called Fanga. And Fanga is a welcoming dance from the West African country of Liberia. During the dance, you will see movements that symbolize from our hearts, meaning with love, with open hands, no hidden agendas, no weapons. We welcome you here today. Thank you.
Yeah. Hello, Upper Darby School District.
What's going on? It's your boy, Mr. Lashley.
And this is Mrs. Figueroa Douglas.
And we're down at 69th Street. We're getting ready to go around the community and interview some of them to find out what they know about Juneteenth and some of their plans.
What do you know about Juneteenth?
What do you know about Juneteenth?
What is Juneteenth?
Like I said, I don't know yet.
I can't really explain that.
I don't know nothing about Juneteenth.
You don't know anything about Juneteenth? Okay.
What is Juneteenth?
Juneteenth is the first national holiday celebrating the freedom of enslaved African Americans. Did I get it right? Did I get it right?
I think you got it right.
Juneteenth is a long time coming.
I know that it's a day to be celebrated. That's what I do know.
It's a celebration of the day of emancipation.
Juneteenth is basically like the celebration for, you know, color folks like myself.
Juneteenth, June 19th, I believe it is. It's just a celebration of black people and, when we were actually free as being slaves and stuff like that. So yes.
That is on point.
It's now an official national holiday.
It's a newer holiday, maybe 2 or 3 years old at this point.
A newer federal holiday, yes.
Yes, federal holiday.
It became a federal holiday when?
I think just recently, right?
Last year.
It's about time we put it on the calendars and recognize it for what it is.
What I'm doing for Juneteenth, hopefully getting a day off from the military.
Man, we're going to get together and have a good time.
We actually take my kids to Malcolm X Park in West Philly, and we let them play around and everything. And then in our community, we actually, like, the kids go around and we have block parties sometimes.
My aunt used to do things with American Legion Post. And we would have a cookout out there in front of the post.
Hope that when I find out where it's at, I will come up and participate and support the cause.
This year, I'll pay more attention.
It's a good thing for us and for everybody else in the community, I guess.
Ms. Figueroa Douglas, I think that video set us up perfectly for what we're about to do. We're going to have a moment. We're going to stop and ask you, what do you know about Juneteenth? So I'm going to give you a fact that I know. I know that Juneteenth is a mixture of two words, June and 19th, and they combine them together. And I also know that Juneteenth's colors, Ms. Figueroa Douglas, is the same colors as the Pan-African flag, red, black, and green. Did I get it right?
You got it right.
You better go ahead. I know
you
got
it right.
I know.
But
I got
did
it right.
You know that Juneteenth is celebrated differently across the nation?
What?
In the Midwest, people attend rodeos. Other people in the South celebrate by attending church services. In the North, people host Juneteenth pageants and parades. But in Upper Darby school districts, we host celebrations.
Come on now. Come on, celebrations.
So, you know what? I think we're a little bit behind schedule because President Ed Brown dropped a lot of Juneteenth facts.
He dropped them gems, Ms. Figueroa Douglas.
He
dropped
did.
Them gems.
He did. So, you
he
know
came
what we're
correct
gonna do?
Today.
You know what we're going to do?
What's up?
We're going to introduce our amazing students of the Upper Darby School District.
Sounds good
they
to me.
They worked extremely hard to put on this program for you. So without further ado.
All right. So listen, I'm going to tell you the next couple acts, and then I'm going to go in the back and enjoy the show like you're enjoying. So the first act we're going to welcome up is going to be the Garifrey Singers, followed by Senko and Hillcrest for their oratorical presentation. And then Aronimink, Primus, Highland Park, Westbrook Park, and Stonehurst is going to do the Hill My Climb by Amanda Gorman. So listen, give these wonderful folks a round of applause, and we're going to listen to the jazz band Kill It while Garifrey comes to the stage. Let's go!
Oh,
morning, everybody. My name is Maxim Ganges. I'm in fifth grade, and I go to Walter M. Senko Elementary School. So, what does Juneteenth mean to me? Juneteenth is America's newest official holiday. But what is a holiday? A holiday is a day to celebrate or commemorate an important event, such as a lesson or achievement, and Juneteenth is both. So, in order to understand what the Juneteenth holiday means to me, we have to understand what it meant to the people that created it and understand what it means to the generations that have followed in their footsteps. Juneteenth was declared a national holiday by Joseph Biden, the 46th president of the United States of America. But first, it was created by the black people it celebrates, to celebrate when the last slaves in Galveston, Texas were freed on June 19th, 1865. First, there was the Civil War. During the Civil War, President Abraham Lincoln signed the Emancipation Proclamation on January 1st, 1863. He said to the slaves that if they helped them to fight the war, they would be free. But this did not free the slaves. That day came 2 years, 5 months, and 18 days later, after many slaves had joined and helped the Union Army reach victory on April 9th, 1865. Even so, it was 71 more days before the slaves in Galveston, Texas knew on June 19th, 1865. The way that the slaves came to know they were free was when the victorious Union Army showed up demanding for Galveston, Texas to free them. But even though the slaves were freed, it didn't go well for them. They just got thrown out onto the streets. Their former masters didn't give them a place to stay or anything. When they asked for soldiers to help them, the soldiers ignored them. Many of the freed slaves died from diseases, but most of them died from starvation, poverty, and struggles against racism. Even though all of this happened, they were still happy that they were freed. So they had their first celebration of Juneteenth on June 19th, 1866. 101 years later, Martin Luther King Jr. gave a new proclamation towards his dream of a more equal and better society. He helped the freed slaves a lot in the 1960s civil rights movement. He stood up for freed black Americans when others weren't doing enough. He did his best to make equal rights for blacks a reality and was killed because of racism. Even so, his dream of equality lived on. In May 2020, black Americans and Americans of all colors marched in force and in unity to proclaim Black Lives Matter. But in January of 2021, the United States Capitol building was overrun by rioters who wanted to overthrow the government to bring about a different agenda. So on Thursday, June 17th, 2021, President Biden made June 19th a national holiday to remind us of our history and celebrate the day that all people were free in the United States of America. President Biden created the Juneteenth holiday to promote hope, hope that racism, like tyranny, would never prevail in America. President Biden also made this a national holiday to celebrate America's spirit and to celebrate one of the greatest moments for America's black people. So, to me, Juneteenth is a statement of hope and a proclamation that America, as a nation, has learned the lessons of the past and that America never wants to be forced to live through those lessons again. To me, Juneteenth is in honor of the struggles and the sacrifices of all the people who have worked hard for equality in this great country. I believe we have Juneteenth to remind us to stand together as a nation against injustice. And I believe it means we have moved on from that chapter in life, and we should never go back. Thank you.
My name is Cadence. I am 11 years old. I am a fifth grader at Hillcrest Elementary School. I think that most people in this room know what Juneteenth is, but if you don't, let me give you some background. Juneteenth is a holiday celebrated on the 19th of June to commemorate the emancipation of enslaved people in the U.S. The holiday was first celebrated in Texas, where on June 19, 1865, in the aftermath of the Civil War, slaves were declared free. Under the law of the 1865 Emancipation Proclamation, and now it's a federal holiday because of President Joe Biden. This is a very special holiday for me and many other people on this ward. This holiday led to other opportunities for African Americans later on. As you have heard or seen, back in the day, lots of African Americans didn't have many opportunities. They didn't even have the opportunity to drink from the same water fountains than white people, or even sit in the same classroom as white kids due to segregation. But now, all that has changed. Personally, I think these past few years, African Americans have a lot of opportunities. For example, Kamala Harris is the first black vice president in the United States of America history. Just like in 2008, Barack Obama was the first black president in U.S. history. Similar to how Raphael Warnock was the first black Georgia senator. Personally, as a young black woman, I think I had a lot of opportunities in and outside of school. And I really think in 2022, African American voices are being heard. However, in the future, I think there will be many more black leaders, because through these years, I have seen many new, young black leaders, such as Amanda Gorman. She is a wonderful poet who wrote the Hillary Climb poem. The Hillary Climb is a powerful call to action focusing on the themes of hope and unity, just as one of Kamala Harris' famous quotes, which says, "Unity is our strength and diversity is our power." These poets, end quote, "so that if you don't work together, you can't move towards success." And they are right. Michelle Obama was the first African-American first lady in USA history. Michelle's parents encouraged Michelle to always work her hardest and try her best in everything she does. "Without Michelle's parents pushing Michelle so hard, she probably wouldn't make it this far in life," she said. "This awesome day is very special for me and many other people in the world. And remember, without unity, we couldn't make it this far. Thank you for your time and have an amazing day."
When day comes, we ask ourselves, where can we find light in this never-ending shade? The loss we carry, a sea we must wade.
We've braved the belly of the beast. We've learned that quiet isn't always peace. The norms and notions of what just is isn't always just is.
And yet the dawn is ours. Before we knew it, somehow we do it. Somehow we have withered and witnessed a nation that isn't broken, but simply unfinished.
We, the successors
of country and time, where a skinny black girl descended from slaves and raised by a single mother can dream of becoming president, only to find herself reciting for one. Yes, we are far from polished, far from pristine, but that doesn't mean we are striving to form a union that is perfect.
We are striving to forge a union with purpose, to compose a country committed to all cultures, colors, characters, and conditions of man. We lift our gazes not to what stands between us, but to what stands before us. We close the divide because we know to put our future first, but we must first put our differences aside.
We lay down our arms so we can reach out our arms to one another. We seek harm to none and harmony for all. Let the globe, if nothing else, say this is true. That even as we grieved, we grew. That even as we hurt, we hoped. That even as we tired, we tried. That we'll forever be tied together, victorious.
Not because we will never again know defeat, but because we will never again sow division. Scripture tells us to envision that everyone shall sit under their own vine and fig tree, and no one shall make them afraid. If they were to live up to their own time, then victory won't lie in the blade, but all the bridges we've made. That is the promise to glade, the hill we climb.
If only we dare, it's because being American is more than a pride we inherit. It's the past we step into and how we repair it. We've seen a force that would shatter our nation rather than share it, would destroy our country if it meant delaying democracy. And this effort very nearly succeeded. But while democracy can be periodically delayed, it can never be permanently defeated.
In this truth, in this faith we trust, for while we have our eyes on the future, history has its eyes on us. This is the era of just redemption we feared at its inception. We did not feel prepared to be the heirs of such a terrifying hour, but within it we found the power to author a new chapter.
To offer hope and laughter to ourselves so wild, once we ask, how could we possibly prevail over catastrophe? Now we assert, how could catastrophe possibly prevail over us? We will not march back to what was, but move to what shall be.
A country that is bruised but whole, benevolent but bold, fierce and free. We will not be turned around or interrupted by intimidation, because we know our inaction and inertia will be the inheritance of the next generation. Our blunders become their burdens.
But one thing is certain, if we merge mercy with might and might with right, then love becomes our legacy and change our children's birthright. So let us leave behind a country better than what we were left with.
Every breath from my brown's pounded chest, we will raise this rounded world into a roundest one. We will rise from the gold-lined hills of the west. We will rise from the windless northeast, where our forefathers first realized revolution. We will rise from the lake-rimed cities of Midwestern states.
We will rise from the sun-baked south. We will rebuild. We will reconcile and recover in every known nook of our nation and every corner called our country. Our people, diverse and beautiful, will emerge, battered and beautiful.
When day comes, we step out of the shade, aflame and unafraid. The new dawn blooms as we free it, for there is always light.
If only we're brave enough to see it, if only we're brave enough to be it.
Let's give these wonderful students a round of applause for their showcase. Let's give them a round of applause. I truly celebrate your hard work to bring those those pieces of art form into fruition in front of them. Orations are a beautiful form of poetry and actual poetry. It's a beautiful thing to see those young people up there. But listen, now we're going to start to have a party a little bit, because the next act I'm going to introduce has a very, very, very important place in my heart. The individuals that I'm getting ready to welcome to the stage are a part of the Phi Beta Sigma Fraternity Incorporated, founded January 9th, 1914, on the campus of Howard University, which is one of the most historical black colleges and universities, even though I went to Lincoln. But shout out to Howard. It's cool. It's all good. So without further ado, I'm going to welcome the brothers of Phi Beta Sigma Fraternity Incorporated. Let's give them a round of applause. Boo! Fight!
Book of Revelation, chapter 7, verses 16 and 17. Yes, sir. They shall hunger no more, neither shall they thirst anymore. Preach, preacher. For God shall wipe away, yes, sir, every tear from their eyes. Yes, sir. Get ready for the revolution. Come on. What you say? Come on.
Good afternoon. Good afternoon. So where's everybody from? I went to Chichester, so I don't know. I don't know about around here. I'm from Derby. Okay. Good afternoon. Okay, that sounds better. So, good afternoon, everyone. My name is Blaine Lewis Thompson, and I'm a brother of Phi Beta Sigma Fraternity Incorporated. Gamma Omicron chapter out of the first HBCU, Cheney University of Pennsylvania. I have my other brothers with me, Aaron Coleman, Christopher Crump, Marvin, and Caleb, all from the Gamma Omicron chapters and Lambda Upsilon chapter located at Westchester University. See, this is a special time to present as a fraternity because Phi Beta Sigma Fraternity Incorporated is part of the Divine Nine. We're founded January 9th, 1914 on the campus of the Howard University Alpha Chapter located in Washington, D.C. We're founded by three great black men, Abraham Lincoln Taylor, Leonard Francis Morse, and Charles Ignatius Brown. Founded on the principles of brotherhood, scholarship, and service, so I hope all y'all grades are okay. Who has A's right now? Who has A's? A's. The letter. The letter. Okay. Who has B's? I'm not going to ask who has C's, D's, and F's because y'all shouldn't have those. So I think everyone has A's and B's here, so that's perfect. So again, we're all about scholarship, and our motto is culture for service and service for humanity. So again, thank you, Upper Darby, for showing out, and I hope you enjoy the rest of the show. Thank y'all.
Lord, Lord, I'm getting old. I'm getting old. I'm only 35 and I'm already out of breath. Miss Figueroa, what's going on? I missed you. How you been? Look at her glistening this afternoon. Woo.
See, this is why I didn't do the electric slide. See, you're out of breath and I'm
good. Yeah, I see. Listen, I tried to get you to come out here and dance with her.
Well, isn't the jazz band doing such a great job? Everyone is doing such a great job, but we are close to the end of the program.
That's
very
right.
Close.
Unfortunately.
But we do have some more acts to share with you. So this is what we're going to do next. We have the Royal Blues Jazz Band. We have Highland Park Concert Band. And then we have a special performance from Upper Darby High School. And they are performing a song, an original piece, Our Truth. Brandon Colon, Christopher Horton, and Alonzo Good.
Let's go.
Let's do it.
Thank you. see my peers who got their brain washed up and got the game messed up. Life, if you slip up, now everybody's so stressed up. I call my feelings a pretty doll. I keep it so dressed up. Look, if you a young black man, they put you out the market. If you a young black man, they put you out the market. Park it, stop the gun violence. Peace will care for a week, and then the victim would say they forgot about me. Now what you think an ideal black man would be? Playing ball, football, tall, built with a strong jaw. You never know the pain that's in me till you be in my 11.5 Nikes. What the popular ones hate me, cause I'm not dumb. I'm breaking inside, begging inside for some freedom. They treat me like an outcast and run past the fact the black community is dying fast. Chris,
all my life rejection's been staring me in the face. There's only few exceptions of acceptance in my space. And since the age of 10, I feel like I can't find a way to win. Bottle all my feelings up just cause the color of my skin. See, the last that shared my pigment, find it hard to show the figment of emotion. Then we hide it. Generations of commotion, just because my social views of black expression. Contradicts with my own experiences and causes mass suppression. But I'm trying to keep it dapper since the kid wanted to be a rapper. The world found out and responded with laughter. Unless I'm rapping through the streets of up to no good. They saying if I'm Hollywood. I never like calling myself a contradiction, but it's like every black man see each other as competition. They profit off this doubt and even got us humanized. They do everything out of the blue except humanized.
Woke up from a vision where I had some better vision, better frames and better lenses, so I can see and warn my siblings of the pain to come. Cause summer dies and rain will come, but God made me four season proof, so now I'm saying something. My vision was a man and he was kicking both his feet up on a chair with full course meal up on the dishes. He sat right next to a well, the one that's made for kids to wish in. He got a suit on and some sunglasses that seemed like they were glistening on the beaming sun. But listen,
why?
I ain't finished. He got done his plate and rubbed his stomach a couple times. The plate had some crumbs. He walked to the well and he dumped inside. The bottom of the well was seven black men who were trapped inside. They fought over the crumbs and then they called it black on black crime.
What?
You see the vision? I know a girl who never truly knew her worth. Her daddy left right after birth and now her personality's a see-through skirt. Her uncle touched her while her mom was on the porch. My complexion, a black man, product of forced intercourse, but then of course we beat slavery to graduate to mental slavery. Don't you see we supposed to help each other, but you hated me. One night I came face to face with a strap killer. I knew he pulled the trigger if I tried to show him who's realer.
Why?
His cousin died last week, he was praying for revenge. He thought it was me and pulled the trigger. When will this all end? I don't know. The only thing that's for sure is if we don't make a plan, who's the plan gonna be for? I'm Alonzo Good.
Let's give it up for Brandon, Christopher, and Alonzo.
Also, while we have a break, let's give the Royal Blues a hand clap for their performance as well as the Highland Park Concert Band.
So now we're at a very special place in the program because our superintendent, Dr. Daniel McGarry, had this vision of awarding students from every school. And what better award than the Opportunity, Unity, and Excellence Award? And what we're going to do is call the name of each student from each school. But there is something very special that teachers and administrators said about each one of these students. And we're going to make sure that all of the students and their parents know what was said about them. But without further ado, because we're a little behind schedule, we're going to call the names of each student. I ask that each student comes up to the stage and receive their award from Mr. Lashley. Nazik Abudaya. Devin Shalias. David Chukwu. Brandon Cologne. Genesis Enoch. Alana Fralin. Giovanni Gonzalez. Noah Henock. Kaimari Hill. Brandon Love. Hanaya Malik. Siobhan Thyme. Marco Vujaskovic. Kyra Williams. Jace Wilson. If our school board president and also superintendent could please stand and take a picture with our award recipients.
In August of 2020, before Juneteenth became a federal holiday, the Upper Darby School District recognized the importance of educating our students about Juneteenth. Social studies teachers for grades 5, 8, and 11 were provided professional development as well as resources for updating curriculum focusing on Juneteenth. Here to share some of that information are our students from Beverly Hills Middle School.
Juneteenth is a holiday celebrated on June 19th annually since 1865 to commemorate the emancipation of enslaved people. However, this holiday is not the exact day that all slaves were freed. All enslaved people were not supposed to be freed 2 months before June 19th, but were kept because they were needed for harvest. The 13th Amendment did not ensure the prohibition of slavery until years later. Juneteenth is not only a day to commemorate the freedom of enslaved people, but to shed light to racial injustice and the lasting effects slavery has on generations to come. We will next read an excerpt of the Emancipation Proclamation.
The people of Texas are informed that in accordance with a proclamation from the executive of the United States, all slaves are free. This involves an absolute equality of rights and rights of property between former masters and slaves, and the connection heretofore existing between them becomes between employer and hired laborer.
Juneteenth means a lot to the people standing here. It is crucial to understand that without Juneteenth and the actions of our ancestors took for the rights of our freedom, we would not stand here and celebrate June 19th as the day of our freedom.
Juneteenth is a holiday for us to remember our history as Black people and the hardships we overcame. I think Juneteenth is important because not only is it a way for us to celebrate our history, but a way for many people to understand our history.
Juneteenth is a pivotal point in both history and in the present day. It was crucial in the past because it was a step forward, and in the present day since it serves as a way to educate yourself more on Black history.
Juneteenth to me is a celebration of honor, love, and freedom. I knew of Juneteenth previously, but this year I've learned so much more about it and what it means. One of the cool facts I learned was that Juneteenth has a flag to represent this holiday.
Juneteenth to me is a representation of how far we have come and the lasting impact we can make when we stand together. Juneteenth is an inspiration to how we can fight racial injustice in the future.
Juneteenth to me is a holiday where we can educate ourselves and learn how history has changed us as a world. So we can learn more about Black history without sugarcoating anything for the sake of television and scared civilians.
Juneteenth to me is a day to celebrate the freedom of enslaved people.
I didn't know about Juneteenth until last year because although this holiday was set in 1865, I never learned about it in school all these years.
Juneteenth to me, hello. Hello, it's on. Juneteenth to me should be a day of remembrance and peace. We should celebrate the importance of what the world was and what the world has become. Without this holiday, our education and society wouldn't be the same.
Juneteenth to me marks one of the many stepping stones we have crossed in our fight for racial justice and equality. Even though it was a joyous day, after that day, they still had hold on us, making petty and unjust laws.
Juneteenth is a recently reclaimed federal holiday that deserves far more recognition than what it already barely has. Juneteenth was a holiday created to commemorate the emancipation of all slaves.
Juneteenth to me is an annual celebration and representation of how far we've come in the fight against racial inequality. This is a big step in the right direction, but it does not mark the end of Black struggles.
Juneteenth is a special holiday for me because I wouldn't want to live in a world where Juneteenth didn't happen. Not many people know about Juneteenth, even me until recently. I'm extremely glad I know about it now, and I pray more people will know about it in the future.
Here we are. We have something very special in store for you today. Thank you. Thank you for joining us today for our first annual Juneteenth celebration. We hope you had a great time. Did you have a great time? So glad to hear it.
So listen, before we leave out, after Amira sings, you're going to be escorted out by our Upper Darby drumline on the way out. So thank you so much again for coming out and enjoying the arts and celebrating the beautiful, beautiful power of what Juneteenth is. Much love to you and thank you. And now, welcome, Amira.
I've been walking with my face turned to the sun. Weight on my shoulders, for the war has to be won. Oh, I've got eyes in the back of my head, just in case I have to run. I do what I can, when I can, while I can, for my people. While the clouds roll back and the stars fill the night, that's when I'm gonna stand up, take my people with me. Together we are going to a brand new home. Far across the river, can you hear freedom calling, calling me? Keep on keeping on, and I can feel it in my bones. Early in the morning, before the sun begins to shine, and I'll fight with the strength that I got until I gonna stand up, take my people with me. Together we are going to a brand new home. For across the river, and you hear freedom calling, calling me to answer. Gonna keep on keeping on.
To the center, I'd really appreciate it. It's not easy to work with the superintendent of schools on a regular basis, and we met to put this together. We had a lot of brainstorming sessions, but I have to say, as a superintendent, it's one of the proudest days I've had in a long time. So I want to say thank you to the two of you for your efforts. And I know we had a jam-packed session today, but please look forward to every single year recognizing this event. Today is just step one, but Chris and Ms. Figueroa Douglas, thank you very much. Awesome, awesome job. I appreciate it.
Concludes the show. On your way out, enjoy the Upper Darby drum line. Thank you. Happy Juneteenth. Enjoy. Much love. Peace.